We begin with that devastating story from Sri Lanka. More than 200 people have been killed and hundreds of others have been wounded in a series of 8 separate explosions. The bombings hit churches and hotels across the country. Seven people have been arrested in connection with the blasts. The government has shut down most social media and a national curfew has been imposed. For more on how people in Sri Lanka are doing, we reached Arjuna Ranawana. He's an editor with thepublicnext.com in the capital, Colombo.
As a community, the Christian community and the rest of the country are in shock because there's a horror at the kind of attacks that have taken place. The holiest day for Christians, and about 6% of Sri Lankans are Roman Catholics, and about 10 to 11% in total are Christians in all. So the two Roman Catholic churches that were attacked were very famous ones. The first is St. Anthony's at Kochikade in Colombo, which is revered by people of all religions. People from who are non-Christians, who are non-Catholics, come there to worship. And it is so well known, and that was the first target. The other one was in close to Nigambo, which is a sort of 90% Catholic area in Sri Lanka. So those two attacks were horrifying. The third attack on a Christian church was in Batticolo on the eastern coast, which was on an evangelical church, the Church of Zion. And those three attacks on Easter Sunday morning was really horrific, and people have not suffered like that. The other attacks on three five-star hotels in Colombo, in was supposedly the safest area of the country, were at the breakfasts, the traditional Easter Sunday breakfast that people have after they finish the vigil, as many Christians would know. And those three attacks also claimed many lives. For the total, 450 injured, 207 dead is really horrific, brings back memories of the war, of the 30-year war that Sri Lanka fought, and that war ended 10 years ago. So people are remembering those things and remembering the tensions, the fear that they had, and that is really upsetting for all Sri Lankans.
That was Arjuna Ranawana. He's an editor for republicnext.com. He was in Colombo. And as we mentioned, the Sri Lankan government is taking some extraordinary measures to control the situation, among them shutting down many social media platforms. For more on what this could mean for the investigation, we reach Sajan Gohel in London. He is the International Security Director at the Asia Pacific Foundation.
The Sri Lankan authorities are concerned about electronic chatter of information going through social media, that it could potentially create further tensions. There could be repercussions from what's taken place. They may also be worried that the fact that these attacks didn't just necessarily happen all together, most of them did, but then we saw subsequent attacks taking place in sequences. So they were perhaps worried that there could be follow-up plots as well. And by closing down social media, which is not going to necessarily be entirely possible, especially if people are using VPN, but by trying to do that, they're hoping that they can isolate where potentially these plotters were involved, who they were communicating with, is there an external hand? Because they do seem to have a fix now as to the people that were perhaps firstly directing this attack or carrying it out. But they want to see if there's a wider network. And by controlling social media, they might be able to ascertain that.
That was Sajan Gohil. He is the International Security Director at the Asia Pacific Foundation. We reached him in London. And Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has responded to the attacks. In a tweet, he calls the news absolutely horrific, saying Canada strongly condemns the heinous attacks on Christians and churches and hotels. He says the hearts and thoughts of Canadians are with the victims, as well as their families and loved ones.